MC Stadium, here on the campus of North Greenville University, where Christ makes the difference. For today's regular season matchup between the Saints of Limestone College and your North Greenville Crusaders. Now it's time for the starting lineups. First, for the visiting Saints. In goal, number one, Greg Purvis. At defense, number two, Nestor Aguilar. At midfield, number eight, Corinthian Gagan. Now it's time for the starting lineups. First, the visiting Saints. In goal, number one, Greg Purvis. At defense, number two, Nestor Aguilar. At midfield, number eight, Corinthian Gagan. At forward, number nine, Luis Robles. At midfield, number 10, Guy Machado. At midfield, number 12, Sebastian Gregerston. At midfield, number 15, Noah Sale. At forward, number 17, Jorge Salvat. At defense, number 19, Sam Hibbert. At defense, number 20, Miguel Anton. At defense, Joe Pei. The Saints are coached by Eric Alsop, assisted by Torin Morris and Scott Simmons. And now, the starting lineups for your North Greenville Crusaders. In goal, a sophomore from Junin, Argentina, number one, Mateo Barzola. At defense, a sophomore from Peachtree City, Pennsylvania, number three, Sam Robertson. At midfield, a sophomore from Didugan, Guam, number four, Marlon Evans. At defense, a junior from Higgins, South Carolina, number five, Lucas Gravely. At forward, a senior from High Point, North Carolina, number six, Jonathan Lynn. At forward, a junior from Antigua, Brazil, number seven, Vitor Tarpinan. At forward, a freshman from Taylor, South Carolina, number 16, Matthew Woodington. At defense, a sophomore from Gastonia, North Carolina, number 19, Jake Quinn. At midfield, a sophomore from Cary, North Carolina, number 21, Casey Brady. At midfield, a junior from Lexington, South Carolina, number 25, Evan Mills. And in midfield, a freshman from Cypress, Texas, number 32, James Segovia. The Crusaders are coached by Bill Martin in his first season at North Greenville. At this time, we ask that you please rise for the invocation given tonight by North Greenville women's soccer player Gabriella Porter, and remain standing as we honor America with the playing of our national anthem.
Let us pray. Dear God, thank you for this day. Thank you for the opportunity that these young men get to come out and play tonight. Lord, let them play for your glory and be injury-free. We pray these all in Christ's name. Amen.
Welcome back to the North Greenville Sports Network. We're ready to get the second game underway between the undefeated Limestone College Saints men's team and the North Greenville University Crusaders. Grace Sutherland back with Dave Parson to bring you game two of today's soccer doubleheader. Dave, another great soccer program, nationally ranked under Coach Eric Alsop, and he's got his squad playing to almost no fault. 3-0 on the road, 3-0 at home. Combine that for the perfect 6-0 record that they have, and they come here to Pesta Stadium looking for their seventh.
Yeah, Gray, they have a complete lineup. Their roster shows 40-some players on their team. I'm sure they're not dressing all those for each game, but they certainly have a lot of talent to pick from, and they're obviously showing it with a 6-0 record.
North Greenville coming in with a record of 1-3-1. The reason why there's another one attached to that is they actually drew against Barton College in a 1-1 tie. So North Greenville officially 1-3-1 on the season coming into tonight's conference matchup against Limestone. And let's see, now that the sun has completely, let's see how fast this pace is.
Yeah, I expect this to be a lot faster pace than the women's game, Gray. North Greenville's key to the game for them is they've got to get shots on goal.
They do. Only one shot in their last home game here at Pepsi Stadium, one shot the whole game. And that was one shot on goal, but one shot the entire game. You'll need more than that to try and get the upset against Limestone, as this shot goes high over the crossbar from number 2, Nestor Aguiar from Spain. Mentioned it during the women's game, a heavy international presence on this team for Limestone. 18 out of the 43 players they have listed on their roster, 18 of those are from U.S. states. The rest are internationals from all around the world. Like, you've got Germany, Norway, England, Spain. We just mentioned Nestor Aguiar, and you've also got the Dominican Republic on here.
Another key to this game is going to be the Limestone ball control and time of possession.
And a good save there by the keeper for North Greenville. Number one, Mateo Barzola, just barely able to get a hand on it as he had a one-on-one situation again with a GR, but a corner kick coming up for Limestone.
Still waiting to see the ball get into the North Greenville Crusaders into the field so they can have a shot on goal.
Cross short, headed away by number 19 for North Greenville. That's Jake Quinn. And a foul against Limestone. We'll keep it with North Greenville. They'll take the free kick. Back to the keeper, Barzola.
Once again, we thank you for joining us on the North Greenville Sports Network for men's soccer tonight from Pepsi Stadium.
Across into the box from number 9, Luis Robles. Deflected away by North Greenville. Number 4 back there, Marlon Evans. And number 5, Lucas Gravely. Ball out of bounds on the far side. Throw in awarded to Limestone.
Once again, it's a beautiful night in Tigerville, South Carolina. A beautiful campus of North Greenville University. Got really nice crowd on the far side tonight, Gray.
Yeah, I even see some people in blue, so some visitors from Limestone have made the trip, as here comes a shot that's off the foot of 15, Noah Sale, high over the crossbar as Limestone had numbers forward. North Greenville able to hold on. So good to see some folks making the trip from Gaffney over. And now that the sun has set and we're almost in full darkness, definitely a lot more comfortable over there.
Absolutely.
There's number 21, Casey Brady, and 25, Evan Mills. As intercepted, Aguiar again for Limestone on the run. Looking back left, cuts it back right, flips it past to number 17, George Salvad, and a shot again high over the crossbar. The volume of shots Limestone's taken early, if they can just get them down lower, they could already be up by 3.
Exactly. Well, that one shot was directly on goal, and Bartolo was really fortunate that he got that left hand on it.
Now North Greenville, see if they can get an attack going as the pass sails out of bounds from number 19, Jake Quinn, and Limestone will throw it back in. Limestone will press down the field. Aguiar looking for number 9. He's intercepted. He was looking for Robles, and now he gets it back. Now the pass connects up with Robles. Robles near side edge of the box. Fire the pass in. Deflected. It stays in bounds. Limestone will try again. Number 15, Noah Sale, comes up. Fires it in. Deflected out by number 12, Chris Inman. And now another high shot that would be good for 3 is no good for 1. That one off the foot of number 8, Quarantine Guagan. From Los Mines, France. Barzola again has to come off as Mark make the save. North Greenville in their traditional home white with black numerals and black shorts with white numerals on those. As another pass stolen away by Savat. Now across to the far side, headed up by Gravely, and no shot to be had. And a goal kick for North Greenville as number 22, Javier Anton, mistimed his kick.
Once again, Gray, the ball hasn't left midfield, or crossed midfield. Still waiting for North Greenville to put something together.
Orzola has a man open on the far side. They go to him. And it's immediately stolen away by the Saints. Now number four for North Greenville, Marlon Evans, come up with a defensive stop. Flips it up. Pass in the middle field. Number 21, Brady, the recipient. Brady gets it across midfield. Fires it back to the far side. North Greenville has number three, Sam Robertson. Or Sam Roberson over there. And now North Greenville goes backwards. That's dangerously close. Robles almost got a foot in there as Berzola fired a pass to Quinn. Now 25, Mills. Chips a shot up. Has a man running down the middle of the field. Headed back. And Brady slipped as he was running down the middle of the field. He was open. And now Limestone counterattacks. And the offside flag from the far side goes up against number 10, Gui Machado from Sao Paulo, Brazil.
As you mentioned earlier, great international presence here for Limestone.
Challenge in the defensive half for Limestone. They get possession back. 19, Sam Hibbert to 12, Sebastian Gergerson, or Gregerson. Gregerson from Tranbjerg, Denmark. Limestone momentarily deflected away by Roberson. Roberson keeps it in play. An overhead kick over on the far side. Saints keep it alive. Now 17, Savat down the middle of the field. Fires it in to number 9, Robles. Robles looking for some help. Gives it to Aguiar. Aguiar has not a lot of help as the ball rolls out, and it will be awarded to the Saints, and this should set them up for a corner kick.
Saints are lining up, putting that play that they've drawn up in the locker room, putting it in place here. North Greenville has to be very vigilant.
Cross comes in, it's high, heading to the right post, headed away by Casey or Jake Quinn on defense. North Greenville trying to get the breakaway, can't do it. Saints send it back into the box. Nothing further doing for Noah Sale and company, who fired it back in, and North Greenville heads down the left wing. Good bit of speed on this Crusader team. Down the left wing they go. They cut it back inside. All right, that's intercepted by the Saints. They'll send it back to their keeper. And the Saints will pull it back. Saints start it again. Looking down the field, Gui Machado going up against Jake Quinn. Machado breaks free momentarily. Now fires a pass to Aguiar. And he goes back to Machado. Now Machado to Savat. Back to Aguiar. Aguiar looking for the cross. Sets one up. Headed away by NGU. Now it lands at the feet of number 12, Sebastian Gregerson. And long shot on the way off the left post. The rebound shot saved by Barzola.
Oh, that was a good save. He chipped it right off the corner.
And Barzola is down in the goal.
Yeah, I think he may have pulled something when he jumped. He gave it his full effort.
Time called on the field to get some help out to look at Barzola.
You mentioned the pace of play, Gray. We've already knocked 10 minutes off the clock in this first half. Seems like it's been a fast 10 minutes.
Been able to pull up the football game for North Greenville, taking on UNC Pembroke tonight. Right now, 9 minutes left to go in the second quarter. Pembroke leading 14-7. They scored at the opener of the second quarter. So North Greenville on defense trying to get a stop and get the ball back to tie it.
We can't thank you enough for joining us tonight on the North Greenville Sports Network. If you can't be with us in person at any of our sporting events, check the athletic schedule to see if your sport or any of the sports on North Greenville's campus is covered on with our video and audio. We're happy to bring you these games. We would like to see you here on the campus, especially on these beautiful nights.
And from here, it looks like they're looking at Barzola's left hand slash arm.
Yeah, his shoulder. He's holding his shoulder.
Trainer's heading off the field, and Barzola's going to stay in.
Yeah, he'll stay in. No blood, so he'll stay in.
In the meantime, Limestone with a throw in. Saints have to tiptoe the sideline to keep it in. Number 21, Joe Pegg. Now here come the Saints. Working inside. Barzola again with the stop. Now it's loose, and it's rebounded in. And that will count. Number 17, number 17, George Savat.
Yeah, rebound goal that time. And Bartolo can't get back up this time. I think he tried to block it with that shoulder being bad.
And so until we can get a confirmation, that looked to be number 17.
Goal by number 17, Jorge Salvat.
And it was number 17, Jorge Salvat, the senior for Limestone from San Sebastian de los Reyes, Spain.
Very good. We're going to have a goaltender change for Crusaders.
The number's really hard to see on the keepers for North Greenville. Black numbers on very dark green jerseys, but the only other listed keeper is actually not listed, but I do believe number 23, James Max Miller, played keeper last year, so he might be back there. And he's going to get an early test. Here comes the ball quickly, and player for Limestone gets behind him. That's number 9, Luis Robles, and it's out of bounds for a goal kick. Low line drive kick lands at the feet of number 12, Sebastian Gregerson. As now North Greenville able to pull possession back. The Crusaders work it down the middle of field. Fast break on the way from number 6, Johnny Lind. And a pass too far in front. And Limestone gets it back.
Before play began, I noticed that the Crusaders had 9 players on the bench with one extra goalkeeper. Well, the Limestone Saints have a full complement of about 10 to 12 players on their bench.
Yeah, it might be we might see the same thing we saw during the women's game where Limestone rotates about 2 to 3 players in every stoppage in time that they can get. So that is James Max Miller back in net in place of Mateo Barzola, who has been pulled out with a apparent left shoulder injury.
Yeah, he's still being evaluated on the bench. He's got his shirt off, so they're looking at that shoulder pretty close now.
So now North Greenville's down 1-0. Limestone's back in their defensive half. We'll have to start over on the attack. Saints Saints working it into some open space. Shot taken and right to Max Miller for the stop from Jorge Savant, who has the lone goal on the scoreboard.
Last game for the Saints was at Lees McRae back on Wednesday. Had a 42 win, so they had two goals scored against them, so they are scorable.
Long pass down the field from North Greenville finds the keeper for Limestone again. And Limestone has a man down the left wing, number 10. Gui Machado cuts it back to the middle, looks, fires a shot, skips it wide right.
Almost had that clean breakaway, Gray.
It did.
Anytime you get behind the defense, it's a good thing for your team.
And stay on side at the same time. We saw the women's team for Limestone do that several times, but three times they were called offside. Now Machado with some open space again. Flips it back to the middle, but nobody home, and cleared out by number 25, Evan Mills. Now Limestone gets possession back. Gregerson doesn't have the shot. Gives it to Quarantine Guigan. Now the Saints cross fired in and not on target as it races to the near side and out. And the throw in for North Greenville coming up.
North Greenville's bench giving their players encouragement here.
And now the ball will go out of bounds. It's a throw in for Limestone. Number 15 gets it, Noah Sale. Now back, long shot deflected. Limestone pulls possession back, Gregerson gets it. Now to the near side for Nestor Aguiar. Aguiar has possession pulled away from him by number 7, Victor Carpinian. Now North Greenville tries to start the attack back the other way. Pressing the advantage, they have room to work with over on the far side. Long pass down the field looking for number 2, James Segovia. And Segovia can't track it down in time as Limestone comes up with a save.
Crusaders have got to get those shots on goal. That's got to be a key to this game for the Crusaders.
Now 17, Savant looking for goal number 2. Runs parallel to the goal, now fires it back to Gregerson. Gregerson over to Aguiar. Aguiar back to Guigan. Guigan slings it in, they had number 10, Machado. Machado fires it and punched out by Max Miller. Corner kick, though, coming up for Limestone. Go with a rolling kick. Now cross-fired in, head to the far side, headed away by North Greenville. They've got to get it out. Here comes a shot, and it's in. Looks like a 20, and that is Miguel Anton, redshirt freshman from Elche, Spain. Limestone leads it.
Goal by number 20. Miguel,
it was an interesting play on that, on the Saints that time. They actually had the corner kick. They could have sent it through, but they just rolled it in. And then that set up almost the same as a corner kick.
Now North Greenville down 2. We've got to get down the field. Got to start pressing the Limestone defense. Chip a pass to the far side. Headed away by Limestone, number 21, Joe Pegg. Number four for North Greenville, Marlon Evans trying to get something going. Gives it to Brady. Brady fires it looking for Segovia. And now this one is skied upward and Limestone trying to turn it around. Here come the Saints, number 10, Machado. To 17, Salvat. And Salvat, a couple of defenders in front of him, and Limestone called for the foul. Max Miller surveying the field, and North Greenville trying to get forward. And the offside flag goes up against Limestone as Machado was away and clear, but jumped away early. Throw in for the far side still with North Greenville.
25 minutes to go in this first half.
Another long clearance by Limestone, trying to get it down the field. Machado's there as well as number 9, Robles. The Saints pick it up again, and a foul call against Limestone as Sale kicks it down the field. Limestone again, constantly pressuring the ball.
Saints showing great defense.
Number 17, Jorge Salvat, ran after the ball, didn't get the play, but then he never broke his stride and turned right around and went back the other way. Now North Greenville looking down the field, nothing doing, trying to find number 16, Matthew Woodington.
When the Crusaders do get the ball on their half of the field, the Saints just are not rattled at all. They're just ready for it.
Saints again pressing forward. Quarantine Guagan. Now North Greenville to the middle of the field for number 4, Marlon Evans. And now Brady goes after it. And Limestone pulls possession again. Number 9, Robles, is offside. Third offside call against Limestone already. And if you can believe it, just over 23 minutes left to play in the first half. Already 12 shots taken by Limestone, 7 of those on goal, and they have cashed in 2 times. North Greenville's Barzola and Max Miller have combined to make 5 saves, but no shots and nothing on goal yet. Foul just shy of midfield in the Limestone defensive half. Gives it back to the Saints.
Saints are definitely showing more speed than the Crusaders tonight.
Pass intercepted there momentarily by number 7, Tarpinian. Limestone and Aguiar get it back. Twenty-one to the far side. That's Peg. Fires one up and punched over the. Well, let's see if he touched it. Yes, punched over by Max Miller as that one was arcing in. Max Miller reached up and hit it out.
And he definitely Miller has the height advantage that Bartolo didn't have. And he just tipped that one over like a volleyball play. Set up that corner kick.
Limestone, last time they didn't fire across in. They rolled it. Now they will roll across in, headed away by NGU. Strong defensive play pays off for the moment. Now Silvat gets it back, breaks free of his defender, fires it, and shot just missed by 19, Sam Hibbert.
Another shot for the Saints. Just under 21 minutes to go in the first half now. Saints up 2-0.
Good high kick from number 21, Peg. And now the Saints cut away by number 19, Jake Quinn. We're 17. For Limestone, almost had it. That was Savad again. Now it's out of bounds. North Greenville, their best position yet with the throw in to Brady. Skips past Brady. Brady now gets it. And Hibbert sticks his right foot in and pulls possession away from him. Number 12, Gregerson again. Now long pass down the field as they have number 9, Robles, open. He's onside. Limestone looking to get numbers forward. Here comes a shot in, deflected away by Quinn.
Crusaders were fortunate there as he almost deflected it back into the goal.
Now entering
just to the left
Saints,
of the goal.
Number 22, Javier Anton.
I have a substitution for the Saints. Number 2, Nestor Aguiar comes out. Number 22, Javier Anton comes in. A brother to Miguel Anton. Another cross for Limestone, heads in. Headed away again by North Greenville. Now can the Saints pull it back? Number 19, Robles, gives chase, keeps it in play. Fires it, looks to number 19, Hibbert, gets deflected away. And now first touch for Javier Anton. Goes to number 10, Machado. Back to the middle of the field for Guagan. And now 21, Peg. Peg with a long shot. That skips past everybody. It'll go out of bounds, and it's off of. Oh, it's Greenville. Throw in Limestone.
Now more substitutions.
Is number 28, Sebastian Marmaleo. And entering the game for the Saints is number 14.
Just under 18 minutes to go in the first half.
Deflection out of bounds by number 32 for North Greenville, Segovia, but it stays with Limestone. Limestone hunting for their third goal here in the first half. Number 18, nowhere to go for Benjamin Noe. From just down the road in Inman, South Carolina, actually went to Chapman. As now North Greenville into the corner for Limestone, but nothing doing against Limestone. In the meantime, up at up in Pembroke, North Carolina, things not looking good for NGU football as Pembroke pouring it on heading into the half. The Braves of UNC Pembroke up on North Greenville 28-7.
Goalkeeper waiting for his team to get in position. Everybody seems to just be walking around out there. No hustle at all.
Brady chips it up to Segovia, but it's cut away by Miguel Anton. And now here's Sam Hibbert. Back to Javier Anton. Number 19, Hibbert again. Limestone taking a little bit of a more methodical approach to work it forward. Long pass to the near side, into the North Greenville bench, a turnover after Sam Hibbert can't connect up to the near side. Now Jonathan Lynn looks for space to run. Long pass over to the far sideline. They got a man over there. And foul, didn't see the flag go up, so a foul called against NGU and free kick taken quickly by Limestone. Also have a substitution for North Greenville coming in and the last timeout that we missed as Limestone looking for their third goal in traffic. Max Miller makes the stop in front of Gui Machado. But that sub was Sebastian Marmalejo in for Evan Mills. I'm showing again, right back to business. They ring two against Max Miller. He gets rid of it. Lynn heads it into the defensive half for Limestone. The Saints again, right to it. Number 8, Quarantine Guigan, and 19. And Sam Hibbert back on defense.
Mostly ball possession for the Saints again. This first half has belonged to them. Saints are always setting up something.
Here's a break for Javier Anton as Johnny Lind closes up close, and it's out of bounds off Lind. And now a couple of more substitutions, 3 in total, 2 on for Limestone, 1 for North Greenville.
Now entering the game, the Crusaders,
Vincent,
number 12, Chris
Vincent Hanman. Weigand comes on.
Coming into the game, the Saints, is
and
number 11,
Douglas
Goderic.
Goderic.
And number 25, Vincent Weigand.
North Greenville also adding in one substitution. That was Chris Inman. Limestone again in business, looking for the long shot. Here it is at the edge of the box. Shot taken high from number 9, Robles. That was hit with such velocity, I'm not sure if Max Miller would have been able to bring that one in. Smack it away maybe, but that one was hit way too hard.
It had a lot of velocity on it, no question about it. Just a little high.
15th shot for Limestone. They have 8 of those on goal. Now they're looking long down the field again. Max Miller has to come up and he makes that stop in traffic again. Douglas Goderic in his face. Another shot sails wide from Go Derek. Max Miller again scoops it up. Just over 12 minutes for North Greenville to try and cut into the Limestone lead. They lead it 2-0 from goals from Jorge Savat and Miguel Anton. Looking for their third here. Vincent Weygand looking for Go Derek, deflected away by North Greenville.
Seems like every time Crusaders get something started, Limestone's right in the passing zone again.
That's right. They get it across midfield, but Limestone drops two or three defenders back and stalls North Greenville out.
And they're very good defenders.
Limestone heading into the box again. Lucas Gravely clears it out for the moment. Limestone have a throw in closest to it. Joe Pegg for the Saints.
11 minutes to go now in this first half. More substitutions.
Trying to build up that healthy rotation again. Number 23, Havard Espejord from Tromsø, Norway.
You would think in Norway they'd spend more time with hockey than they would soccer.
That's another long pass into the box, headed away by Jake Quinn. That'll set Limestone up with a corner.
With that two-goal lead, there's no sense of urgency here.
Here comes the cross. First touch by North Greenville. Out of the box it goes. Limestone's going to get it back. Number four, Marlon Evans, saves the day for the moment. And he goes out of bounds, throwing for the Saints again. Limestone in business down the right wing. Number 14, Connor Young. As Limestone's intercepted, North Greenville is counterattacking.
Good block there by North Greenville.
Johnny Lind running free down the sideline. But the header from number 22, Javier Anton, wins it back for the Saints. Down the middle of the field, headed back toward the keeper, Max Miller, who comes up to make the stop with help from Gravely. Long kick by Max Miller. This one covers almost two-thirds of the field. But Limestone gets it back, and now they're going to close that gap in a hurry. Number 9, Robles can't get to it. Number 25 does. That's Vincent Weygand. Long pass into the box, deflected away again. Now here comes number 9, Robles, looking, doesn't have the shot, and it's sent out of bounds by North Greenville.
Now entering the game for the Crusaders is number 8, David Becerra. And number 24, Cameron Ward.
Just heard there, David Becerra and Cameron Ward getting in the ball game for NGU.
Yeah, North Greenville seems to be getting a little desperate now.
Limestone setting up for a throw in. Actually, a free kick. This kick going long, carrying over the far side. North Greenville's not going to have a problem handling that one as number three, Sam Roberson, gets it. But again, Limestone trying to bounce it right back. There's Quinn with the timely header. And out of bounds, throw in for Limestone.
Once again, Gray, I think this is Limestone's plan for tonight, to spend most of the time in the offensive zone.
And once again, dominating in ball control. Another shot into the box, header over the cross. Actually, it's saved by Max Miller. It looked like it was going to hit over the crossbar, but Luis Robles again on target. Limestone has it deflected out. Quick throw in taken by number 23, Havard Espiord.
It was a good block by the Crusaders player.
Now number 25, Vincent Wagand, looking down the field. North Greenville deflecting it back. Number 8, David Becerra, getting in on the defensive play.
Exactly 5 minutes left on the clock. But the Saints having a two-goal lead, they're not in any hurry to set anything up.
Heading into the far side corner, North Greenville's got possession, running out of real estate quickly. They finally dump it back down the sideline. And Limestone gets it back. Number 11, Guderick, looking for the cross. Chris Inman comes up to help support the defense. Now another nice long shot, looking into the box, headed on goal, and Max Miller with a diving save.
That was a good save. That was headed right for the corner.
Luis Robles has had two straight shots on goal, but Max Miller has been there to stop them both.
Good hand by the crowd on that play. It was a very good one.
Now Lynn. Lynn looking with David Becerra. Now here's number 28, Sebastian Marmolejo. As his pass long and out of bounds, looking down the field for Vitor Tarpinian. And Limestone counterattacking, 3:20 left to go in the half, first half, that is. Marlon Evans trying to get something going. North Greenville has got to get down the field and take some shots. Here's Sam Roberson. Nothing doing. North Greenville hung up around midfield. Now Lind, as his pocket's picked by Luis Robles, and Limestone on the counterattack. Saints again, there's Espiord to Javier Anton. 25, Wagon. For 15, Noah Sale. Looking into the corner for and Javier. And it's out of bounds off NGU. Throwing for the Saints. 2 minutes to go and the half. Limestone looking for a third. Here comes a shot. Max Miller dives in front of it. And cleared out by Inman, but not so fast. Luis Robles, who just had his third straight shot on goal, gives it to number 15, Noah Sale. Limestone looking for the cross. Here it comes, headed away by Jake Quinn. Lands at the feet of Wagand. Wagand's shot's deflected. And once again, he gets a good bounce. Good challenge there by Sam Hibbert, the senior defenseman from Warrington, England.
And the Saints right in the passing zone again.
And now North Greenville trying to get right in the passing lane. Again, Jake Quinn, pass deflected away. Final minute of the first half.
1 minute remaining.
Limestone's up by two. They're looking for three. North Greenville trying desperately to jar it away from Limestone and get down the field, running out of time. Javier Anton to 23, Havard Espiord. Now a long shot taken and misses wide left from Limestone. Goal kick for Max Miller with at just over 15 seconds.
10, 9.
So as the clock counts down, Max Miller will retrieve it and don't think he'll go for the goal kick. And Max Miller will take us to the half. 2-0, Limestone leads it after 45 minutes of play.
Yeah, once again, Gray, we talked about how North Greenville, their key to the game is to get down in the offensive zone and get shots, and that's not happening tonight.
See if the second half bodes any better. Limestone in control right now over North Greenville. We're at the half between North Greenville and Limestone in men's soccer here on the North Greenville Sports Network.
Greenville would like to take this time to thank its sponsors, Pepsi, Catazoom Custom Wraps.
Just about to get the second half underway between North Greenville and Limestone. The Saints tallied up two goals in the first half, and from the way they've been able to pressure the North Greenville defense, it looks like they want a few more.
This game started out similar to the ladies' game earlier this evening with two goals in the first half for the Limestone Saints.
And those two goals for Limestone come courtesy of Jorge Silvat and Miguel Anton. 17 shots for Limestone, 10 of those on goal. Six corners, two fouls, three times called offside. The big stat line for North Greenville, still no shots taken on goal yet. Eight saves combined, though, for Mateo Barzola, who had to exit the game due to a left shoulder injury. And since then, James Max Miller has taken over. And North Greenville's tallied up eight saves. They've gotten three fouls as well. And that is the stat line right now. So Limestone dominating the stat line on paper and on the field.
Yeah, definitely on the field. They've had the ball on their end of the field most of the night.
An undefeated squad, 6-0 on the season for Coach Eric Alsop. As his Saints playing like a well-oiled machine. Still time to rally, though, for North Greenville, only down two.
A lot of soccer left.
There's Limestone once again and on the attack. Number two, Nestor Aguiar. And number five, Aaron Dowsett. And Dowsett from Holywell, Wales. As North Greenville able to intercept and start counterattacking the other way. Vitor Tarpinian with it. Looking forward to number 32, James Segovia, but it's cleared out by Limestone. Out of bounds, though, and the Crusaders will have a throw-in.
I believe that was the first serious turnover that the Crusaders have forced.
Casey Brady gets it. Has two defenders on him, though, and can't get out of it. As now Limestone under pressure. They're able to clear it. Here's Gravely coming up to play. Slings it to the near side. Almost headed on goal by number eight, David Becerra. And now this one will sail out of bounds and off the roof. Out of the scorer's table and out of bounds. It'll be a throw-in for North Greenville. And a foul against NGU. Limestone will set up for a free kick. Nestor Aguiar has it, bringing it across midfield. Number 23 now for Limestone, Havard Esbjord. Limestone goes back across midfield. Greenville intercepts. Number eight, trying to turn around and counterattack, David Becerra. And number three, Sam Roberson. Number 28, Marmalejo, turns it over to Limestone. The Saints counterattacking, shot taken, saved by Max Miller off the foot of Sebastian Gregerson.
Add another shot on goal.
That puts them at 11 out of 18.
Just an observation, North Greenville Crusaders seem to be using their feet to try to get fancy with the ball instead of passing, and I think it's coming back against them.
Limestone back across midfield. Gregerson has it, working with Connor Young. And it's out of bounds off of the Saints. North Greenville will get it back. And open on the near side. Land has room to run. Has to track down the ball, though. Gets it. Then cuts it back toward the middle. Now runs into a wall of defenders. Goes back to the corner for Sam Roberson. Crosses it in. It bounces off of number 7, Victor Tarpinian. And Tarpinian goes down in the box as it will be a throw-in for North Greenville as Tarpinian is still down. Now he gets up. Referee goes over to check on him. Tarpinian gets up okay, showing no ill effects. North Greenville with a good chance here 6 minutes into the second half. Cross into the box at right to the keeper's hands.
Limestone Saints still sitting on that 2-goal lead. Methodically working the ball down the field, looking for the open guy.
They might have one here as this one will roll, missing the right post. And a goal kick for Max Miller. A good long kick from the foot of Max Miller. Nice header by Brady as North Greenville trying to push forward with Brady and Lind. And Limestone crashes in with Espiord. And now the Saints back the other way. Number 17, Jorge Silvat. And cleared out by North Greenville. Lind somehow keeps it in. We play on.
Seems like the Crusaders, when they do make a good play, save the ball inbounds, there's no help there. They've got to get some offensive players down the field.
Cross in for Limestone. Max Miller again comes up with the save. And it must have been that header from number 7, Vitor Tarpinian. But North Greenville has picked up a shot on goal, so they have one for the game. As Max Miller has to dump that one as he had Connor Young crashing in on him. Greenville again looks to Lynn. And that pass cut away. Number 2, Nestor Aguiar with some open space. Passes forward. Shot flipped up to the near side. Back to the far side. Here comes number 10, fires it in, and it is good from the foot of Gui Machado.
Just like the ladies' game, Saints are starting to run away now. 36-19 left in the game.
And Machado with his fourth shot nets himself his first goal of the game.
Goal by number 10,
Gui
Machado.
North Greenville now down 3-0, faces a more difficult challenge. Ball takes a roll out of bounds, favorable to the Crusaders for a throw-in. Trying to get Casey Brady open in the corner, cleared away by the Saints defenders. Now 23 SPR challenged him, stripped of the ball. Gus Johnson gives it off to number 7, Tarpinian, but he can't do anything with it. Limestone again comes up with another defensive stop. Send it back to the keeper, and they'll start over. Wagand to the far side. Nothing doing for Limestone. They're back across midfield. Now here comes number 5, Aaron Dowsett. Long down the field looking for a Giar, cut away by North Greenville, but now it's picked up by Salvat. Into the box. Here comes a shot. Stopped by Max Miller with one hand off the foot of Connor Young.
Almost a brilliant save at the end line to save the corner kick. Just got out of control, just over the line.
Limestone setting up for that corner kick.
Now coming into the game for the Saints is number 15, Noah Sale.
Here's Noah Sale coming back on for Limestone. Saw extensive playing time in the first half. And Sale also adding to the shot total for Limestone. Limestone, he has had a shot as there's a collision in the box. Referee might say this will be a retry on the free kick. And they're going to redo the kick.
Ref, how is that not a foul coming out?
We'll try it again. Long high cross and foul against Limestone. Turns it over to North Greenville. Again, lots of contact in the box. We'll reward North Greenville with the ball. Now North Greenville bringing pressure against the ball, forcing Limestone to make some quick passes, see if they can force that bad pass and get a turnover off of it. Number 3, Vebjorn Olstein from Sarpsborg, Norway. Back to number 2. There's a Giar. And almost a turnover force there. And we still might actually have a no. Limestone's able to keep control of it. Number 25, Wagon, gets away from the pressure. Now North Greenville gives chase into the corner. Limestone continuing to try and get a foot in there and intercept it. They do so. 12, Gregerson sticks a foot in. And Limestone looking for goal number 4. Long shot in the box, headed wide right. Almost a goal for number 14, Connor Young, but not quite.
Every player on the field walking to their position. Nobody showing any enthusiasm to get in position. I'm really surprised that they're not giving it more effort on either side right now.
Number 16, Matthew Woodington, making a return to the field. Max Miller, another long kick, headed back his way by Limestone. Now Greenville picks it up. Pass to Lynn. Lynn to the middle. Through the defender's legs, Lynn looking for the pass to number 32. He didn't get it to Segovia. North Greenville not done yet. Here comes Brady. Brady trying to turn around the edge. Fires it in. Headed away at the last second by Aguiar. Ball rolls out of bounds. It will be Saints ball.
Just over 30 minutes left in the game now.
Now another fast break on for the Saints. Number 10, Machado, away with the ball. Has it deflected by number 4, Marlon Evans. Now headed back by the Saints. Number 19, Sam Hibbert. Foul called against Limestone, North Greenville ball. On a free kick. Long down the field looking for Segovia. Out of bounds, and it will be back with the Saints. From the football field in at UNC Pembroke, North Greenville trying to fight their way back into the ball game, still down two scores, 28-14. Pembroke leads it, 5:47 left to go in the third quarter. Now North Greenville ball as they continue to battle it out down the far sideline, working ever closer to that corner flag. Now a short cross headed away by number 19 against Sam Hibbert. Everywhere at once. And again, out of bounds off Limestone. North Greenville continuing to get some breaks. Now they got to get some shots. Number 3, Sam Roberson, fires it down the field looking for Lind. Instead, it's picked up by number 16, Woodington. Woodington looking for Lind, partially deflects it, headed back. Lind's going to try and hit it on goal. And that pass, he was looking for Tarpinian. It's headed away by Limestone again. And the offside flag goes up against North Greenville, against number 16, Woodington, running down the middle of the field.
The clock is definitely favoring the Saints. Just under 28 minutes to go in the game. 3-goal lead. They're not in any hurry.
Saints down the middle of the field, fire a pass over to the far side. Good pass from the foot of Wagand. Number 3 for the Saints, that's Olstand. And a sharp whistle foul against North Greenville will set Limestone up with a free kick. Fourth foul puts each team with 4 fouls. But no cards yet. Ref has been very good at letting them play on.
Crusaders have to be very careful here now.
Official puts down the line to mark where the wall will be. 4-player wall stands up. And here comes the kick. Chip shot up into the box. Max Miller skies and gets it down. Now looking for the fast break to Brady. Brady has 2 defenders stuck on him, and it's kicked back over his head. Headed back by Limestone. Now back by NGU. And the offside flag goes up against 2 different Saints or behind the defense. This pass sent all the way to the near side, Limestone will get it back with the throw in. Quinn. Taints again pressuring. 25-12. That's Wagon to Gregerson. Wagon fires it down the sideline. Number 9, Luis Robles. Now some open field, cross into the box and wide of his intended target. Looking for Connor Young down the middle. That one from number 17, Jorge Salvat. He's picked up a goal tonight, looking for the assist. And a hard challenge. Gets a foul called against Limestone. North Greenville trying to take it quickly down the field. 25 minutes to go in the second half. Lind to number 8. Becerra. Becerra works his way inside. He gives it to number 16, Woodington. Now Brady. Brady back left to Roberson. Roberson into the corner for Becerra. Becerra looking, and he gets called for a foul. And no card, referee just having some words with him. But a free kick for Limestone. Battle for it at the sideline. It rolls out. Ball goes back to North Greenville. Again, trying to turn the edge. You got Woodington. Strips. Number 2 comes up with it for Limestone and Guiar. And now the Saints off to the races as Salvat fires a pass down the field. You've got Olstad running. Here comes across into the box. Man open. And no shot taken yet. Limestone still trying to line it up with 12. That's Gregerson. Now another cross deflected out. Brady got a piece of that one from number 3, Olstad. But Saints still with a throw in. Two changes coming on the field for North Greenville. One for Limestone. Nick Roberson comes in, number 20.
Looks like the Crusaders have another player with a shoulder injury.
Johnny Lind is going to come to the sideline to get checked out. Chris Inman also came in for NGU, number 11. Douglas Guderick from Stockholm, Sweden. Comes in as the Saints looking for their fourth goal as it's tipped out from Max Miller as that one was going to Goderick all the way, who just came in. Let the Saints get another shot here with a corner kick.
A lot of good saves by the Crusaders goalkeeper, but that just means that the Saints have had a lot more shots on goal.
15 shots, in fact. 12 saves for NGU.
Come on, Sammy.
High cross, heads to the left post, headed away by NGU. And a throw in from the other sideline. Limestone, established possession off the throw-in. Now the pass deflected. Casey Brady caught a piece of it from Wagon. Limestone driven back all the way to the goalkeeper. Now Dowsett gets pressured, fires it right, has a man. That's number 2 at Guiar. Now back to 25, Wagon. Looking down the middle for number 9, Robles. Off the deflection, Salvat gets it to the near side corner. Aguiar again has his cross deflected up in the air. It lands in play. Takes a limestone hop. And now a battle ensues between Aguiar and number three, Sam Roberson. North Greenville defends at the edge of the box. The shot chipped back in. This one will take a bouncing header and roll out. It will be a goal kick for Max Miller as Jorge Salvat came dangerously close to scoring again.
Once again, the Crusaders dodged a bullet again. Another shot on goal, I believe.
Limestone continuing to push their already shot total up higher.
Approaching the final 20 minutes of the game.
Ball chased out of bounds by Aguiar for Limestone, 16 Whittington for NGU, Saints ball for off the throw-in. And I'm counting three changes for Limestone. One of those, number 8, Quarantine Glagan, 21, Joe Pegg. Those two are coming back onto the field, and Limestone looks like they're going wholesale changes. Miguel Anton also on.
Now coming into the game for the Saints is number 8,
Quarantine. And 32, Jeremy
20, Miguel
Cheeks.
Anson. And number 32, Jeremy Cheeks.
Offside flag goes up against. Oh, the offside flag went up, but Limestone must have been a foul against North Greenville, so Limestone gets the ball. Limestone still looking for number 4. They have a comfortable 3-goal lead at the moment. Miguel Anton going to the far side, trying to get Quarantine Glagan involved. Glagan runs out of room, connects back up with Anton. And now number 11, Goderick. Number 3, Olstad. 20, Miguel Anton to 21, Joe Pegg. Pegg looking, fires it left, where Limestone has room. North Greenville crashes in with a defender, Nick Roberson. North Greenville defense at their edge of the box. Matthew Whittington gets held up long enough for Limestone to retake possession. Mistimed header there. And it will roll out, go back off the Saints as good decision there by Nick Roberson to let it go, and he gets the ball back for his Crusader team. I'm still pressuring again down the left wing. Jeremy Cheeks leading the charge. Now 17, Jorge Salvat. Works into the box, gets around two defenders, working on his third. Salvat fires it back, bounces off a couple of defenders, and North Greenville able to get it out just outside the edge of the box before Limestone pulls possession back. Now a laser beam shot saved by Max Miller from Quarantine Glagan.
Seems like whenever the Crusaders get the ball, there's at least two Limestone Saints right there to take that ball away.
Great pursuit by Limestone. They are all over where North Greenville is trying to pass. Max Miller is going to be called upon again, getting the deflection from Sebastian Marmolejo. Down the sideline, North Greenville trying to get things going. Whittington gets called for the foul and a yellow card.
Hey, hey, come on, come on, come on.
issued. I'm still with a free kick, and now North Greenville with the yellow card. Limestone again pressing, long shot, it goes in, top right corner.
Laser shot.
Number 17 again.
Number 17, Jorge Salvat.
Yes, it was, Jorge Salvat picking up number two.
That was a terrific shot. Just played right in the upper right corner.
I don't think he was worried about that one not going in.
Nothing the defender could do with that one. And it seems familiar, just like the first game with the ladies. Saints up 4-0 coming in late in the game. Just under 16 minutes to go now.
Number 14, Connor Young will come in and take the spot of your most recent goal scorer, number two for Jorge Salvat. Limestone again intercepts, number five, Aaron Dowsett. Greenville is starting to bring some pressure now against the ball, crashing in. Limestone is able to pass away from it every time. Dowsett goes back to Saints keeper, who rips it down the middle of the field to number 20, Miguel Anton. Anton looking down the field for Goderic. Goderic outraces Quinn, picks up the ball, slings it back to the middle of the field, but his intended target overran the pass, and now North Greenville will send it down the field. Again, Limestone sends it back the other way.
Crusaders just can't seem to put anything together when they do get the ball. It's all Saints tonight.
Good sliding tackle by Jake Quinn to rid Limestone of possession for the moment. Now North Greenville able to pull it back again. Limestone and Goderic intercepts it back, and now the Saints on the move. Number eight, Quentin Guagan. Back across midfield. Now a tangle up on the far side. Limestone wins again. Goderic gets the pass. Now we go back to Guagan again. Now five, Dowsett. Looking for 21, they have Peg. To number eight, Guagan again.
The Saints are happy to just get all their players involved. Good passing.
Hard challenge in Limestone's attacking half, North Greenville's defensive half. Limestone player slow to get up. Vebjorn Olstad is now up and moving around. Okay, we resume play. Chris Hinman steps in front of the pass, but only deflects it to another Limestone player. Number 20 picked up that loose ball, Miguel Anton. Now North Greenville trying to turn around Limestone's edge. They'll do so. Limestone now bringing two players crashing in, make it one, as Max Miller gets rid of it just before Goderic can pull it away from the goalkeeper. Again, Limestone pulls it away from Brady that time.
Once again, two Saints right on the ball.
Limestone able to keep it in. Now can they pull it back? Doesn't look like they can. And ball back to the Saints. North Greenville unable to hang on to it.
Number 7, Vitor Tarpinian. And number
24, Vitor Tarpinian back in. Cameron Ward also back in for NGU.
Jay Odom.
And one more, number 26, Jay Odom.
And number 22, Javier Anton.
Javier Anton making a reappearance to the field. And number 18, Benjamin Noe again. Now Limestone on the move quickly. North Greenville steps in the way as number 21, Joe Pegg, had a run. They're able to stop him. Back heel from Chris Inman. Finds Sam Roberson. Roberson now pressing down the field. Finds Cameron Ward. Ward gets it forward. North Greenville might have a chance here. See if they can get a shot. No, at the last, right at the edge of the box, deflected away by Miguel Anton. Best run of the night, though, for North Greenville. Something they can build off here in the final 10 and a half minutes.
Limestone Saints are just too much for the North Greenville Crusaders tonight. This is a very good soccer team. The record shows it, and their rankings show it.
That it does. Limestone, a perennial powerhouse in just about every sport within the Conference Carolinas. So it's not just one team, it's about all of them. And now Limestone hunting for number 5. Trying to line up a shot, nothing doing. And North Greenville able to get it out of there in time.
Now entering the game for the Crusaders is number 32.
I have a keeper change for.
And coming in for the Saints is number Limestone. 0, Connor Washer.
Number 0, Connor Washer will now be your new keeper as he will replace number 41, Thomas Osborne out of Somerville, who played 80 minutes in goal for Limestone and has come up with one save tonight. But that's because North Greenville only has one shot on goal. Number 24, Cameron Ward, able to stick a foot in there and pick a ball, pick possession up momentarily. Limestone on the counterattack, though, after getting the ball back. Benjamin Noe hunting for the back of the net, can't get it. Now here comes a shot, deflected out. Jake Quinn again able to stick a foot in there. Another shot bouncing loose in the box. And now Limestone has to get it back in after it rumbles all the way through. Cross into the box, mistimed header, and the relay shot off the crossbar. It spun off the crossbar. We play on a third cross. Headed away again by North Greenville. Limestone a fourth chance. And a line drive careened out by Quinn. And finally, the ball's kicked out off the foot of number 22, Javier Anton, and North Greenville ends the threat.
Good defense that time by the Crusaders. Able to hold them out and get the ball back.
Crusaders again trying to work the middle of the field, but Limestone has two defenders there.
Now coming into the game for the Saints is number 9, Luis Robles. Number 24, Jake Perito.
Again, multiple changes for Limestone. Number 9,
Luis
Robles.
Carballo.
Number 28, Luis Carballo out of Santiago, Dominican Republic. And immediately gets his first touch, does Carballo. Carabalo. Now Robles gets it. Limestone works it backwards. Greenville trying to get a long pass down the field to number 7, Tarpinian. A Limestone able to escort him and pick up the ball.
It's a good idea, but he had no help back there.
Sliding interception by North Greenville gets away from number 28, Marmalejo, and it stays with the Saints.
Getting late in the game, but the Saints are still swarming the ball.
Yeah, they want to post up. No goals allowed on the scoreboard. Pass too long, looking, trying to find number 24, get it to Cameron Ward that time. No dice. Past the 85th minute, under 5 to go. Limestone again, flying down the right wing, back to the middle of the field, and Carabalo almost had a shot at it as number 31 with the sliding challenge, Gus Johnson, able to pull it back for North Greenville. Max Miller will have to send one deep, see if he can jumpstart this offense. Quinn looks down the field, a pronouncing header from the head of Miguel Anton to try and get it back for the Saints, and he will do that. It's number 0, Connor Washer. Out of Evans, Georgia. Actually, that's the same town and high school as a couple players on the women's team for Limestone. Yeah, Emily Ludwig from Evans, Georgia, and Greenbrier High School. And the Bowl sisters, both of them from Evans, Georgia, and Greenbrier High School. Now two players back. Two Limestone Saints down, so two players down for Limestone. Meanwhile, North Greenville at the other end. Attack is stopped, and the referee will stop play with 2:46 to go while both of these Saints are checked on. After tonight, we'll be back over at Hayes Gymnasium next Tuesday night for women's volleyball in a non-conference matchup against South Atlantic School Brevard, and first serve at 7 p.m. over at Hayes. Women's volleyball coming off a tough battle last Wednesday against Southern Wesleyan in five sets. The Warriors pulled that one out and set an uphill battle for conference games. As North Greenville continuing having to try and keep the ball away from Limestone, number nine, Luis Robles, getting after it again.
Coming up to 2 minutes left in the game now. 4-0. Same score as the early game with the women playing.
North Greenville won. Good chance if they can get down the field. And that attack quickly stopped. Tarpinian again trying to get open down the field, and Limestone again gets in the way. Good back heel from Chris Inman. And now Inman looks to go to the corner. Inman trying to get across, overruns the ball, gets tripped up, and a foul called. Ball continues to run, got to set it up for the free kick. Inman gets it set.
Coming right at 1 minute here.
1 minute remaining.
Now they switch out free kick takers. Ward to do it. Ward fires it to Segovia. Back to Ward. Ward looking. Headed away by number five, Dowsett. And the wild shot skips right of the right post, and Limestone can just try and run this one out with 30 seconds left.
Clock still running down to 20 seconds. No hurry.
Limestone's going to send it deep anyway. See if they can get number, try and get number five. Robles running after it. And now it's intercepted by Young. 10 seconds left. Long shot right to Max Miller for the save. And that will less likely be the final save of the game. And Max Miller takes us to the horn. Full time here at Pepsi Stadium. Limestone wins it. 4-0 over North Greenville. Limestone stays perfect on the season. 7-0, 4-0 in conference play. North Greenville drops to 1-4 and 1-0-3 and 1 in conference play.
Will be Thursday, October 6th versus Emmanuel College at 7:30.
Well, Dave, you got plenty of talent here on both rosters. Limestone puts four goals up on the board. Jorge Silvat with two of them. Guy Machado with one, and Miguel Anton with one. Plenty of defensive stoppage power for Limestone. Who do you like as player of the game?
I'm going to defer to you on this one. It was so even. Every one of the Limestone players deserved some accolades tonight.
Well, I really do like what Salvat was able to do, but I really want to go to a defender on this one. And I believe I have to give the nod to number five, Aaron Dowsett. The Welshman was always back there and able to stop North Greenville.
Yeah, I have to agree with you on that call. I think North Greenville, they've got to reevaluate their offense now. I think he might have had two shots on goal the whole game, just one on goal. I didn't know if that last one was a shot on goal or not.
I don't think they counted it. Meanwhile, 27 shots for Limestone, 19 of those on goal, eight corners, one shot, lone shot on target for North Greenville. Max Miller and Barzola combined for 15 saves. And Segovia had the lone shot for North Greenville. That was James Segovia.
Well, the Limestone Saints will play again on Wednesday night at 7 p.m. at Wingate. They'll take their perfect record in there. See if they can keep that streak alive.
And North Greenville just announced over the LOUT, the PA system, their next home game won't be until October 6th. here at Pepsi Stadium, and a good chance it'll be a little bit cooler then too. So that'll do it here for us from Pepsi Stadium. Limestone sweeps the doubleheader from North Greenville. And so for myself, Grace Sutherland, Dave Parson, on camera tonight, Christian Athey, Mason Freitas, and producer Alan Cahaley. This has been the North Greenville Sports Network.